Oh my gosh! Hello friends and welcome back. So today I have another magical unboxing for you. I know, it's crazy. Don't worry though, I still have exciting bookish content coming your way, but for now it's another magical unboxing because somehow all these boxes just arrived within the same week and I have a lot of catching up to do. So today it's time for the Wizarding Trunk Special Edition, and if you haven't noticed my wand yet and my cork necklace, it's themed Exceptionally Ordinary, so it's all about Luna Lovegood. This box contains 9 to 12 items, so I'm ready to go. And if you like these kind of videos, then don't forget to click that subscribe button and hit that bell so you never miss another video of me again. Let's get unboxing. Little confession before we start, Luna Lovegood is not my favorite character. I know that for a lot of you guys she is, but for me it is and always will be Hermione Granger. When we open this box, we can see a paper item on top and beneath that a lot of items, you guys. This box is packed. And of course, a big thank you to my patrons. You guys help me keep this channel running. For only €3 a month, you can support me as well. And there are higher membership levels that of course come with more benefits. And the money for my patrons goes into subscription boxes, custom fees, shipping costs, and of course, better equipment. So if you feel like it is something for you, come join us, head over to patreon.com, type in my name, Leanda Brooks, or click on the link in my description. It feels like there could be a potion bottle in here or some bigger items because the box is pretty heavy. On top is of course the spoiler card, but on one side they made it look like it's a list from Luna of all the stuff that she lost, like a pair of school shoes and one bottle of blue ink. Let's put that aside for now. I've spotted something and I'm gonna grab that because if you remember the Litjoy Crate unboxing, the Big Seven, there was this Luna item that was a scarf. I wasn't a fan of that item. I was, however, a fan of the add-on that I didn't get, the lion heads. And this first item looks a little bit like a lion head, so fingers crossed, you guys. It is, it's the freaking lion head. Now I'm kind of glad that I didn't get the Litjoy Crate add-on. I have no idea how the lion head from Litjoy compares to this one, but this looks awesome. Okay, seriously, hairs are flying everywhere. This is fantastic. It looks so good. And am I gonna wear it? Definitely not. I am never gonna leave my house with this hat on. Or screw that, maybe if I'm cold I am gonna wear this because it's made out of wool and it's so comfy and it keeps your ears warm and it kind of looks okay. Oh my gosh, I got myself a lion head. I am so curious to know how many hours it took to make just one hat. Amazing start to the box. I don't know how they got there, but there's like two hairs on my tongue now. I think I found out why this box is so heavy. The last special edition box was themed around the groundskeeper, so Ruby is Hagrid. And in that box, there was this candle, roasted gingerbread rock cakes. And for me, it was just a candle, so there was no label on it. I emailed the Wizarding Trunk and I told them that, and they said they will ship the label with the next box. But instead, they just gave me the entire candle. And they didn't have to do that because I just asked them for the label, but they send another candle, so that's great customer service. There's a wooden item lying on top, so let's take that one. I think this is a really cute item and you instantly know that it is about Luna. I just never know what to do with these kind of items. What do you guys do with these kind of items? Do you use them as ornaments or do you have another idea? Let's go for a little box. We have some pink tissue paper. Oh, that is so cute. It's a little dirigible plum tree. I don't even know if I'm pronouncing that correctly. Dirigible? Dirigible. But oh my gosh, you guys, the cuteness of this little tree. And it even has a little sign that says keep off. This item will fit perfectly on my Luna Lovegood shelf. I think we have a wand, but I'm not entirely sure. I mean, yeah, what else could it be? It's definitely a wand. But the reason I said I'm not entirely sure is because I don't recognize it as a character wants. I think it's their own take on Luna Lovegood's wand. It's a perfectly round wand with a very light wood color, and on the wand are dirigible plums, leaves, and acorns. I'm gonna be honest with you guys, I think this is a nice wand, but I'm not blown away by it. I think it's a little bit too plain. I love that they did this engraving on it and their own take, I think, of Luna Lovegood's wand, but it's just a little bit too minimalistic for me. I mean, it could have also been a giant chopstick. It does look a little bit like a chopstick. I'm sorry, that's not nice, but it just doesn't feel that magical to me. And after all the wands that I got from Giga Wizardry, and of course the official wands that I own, this is definitely not my favorite. Let's go for the pin next. Ooh, I see something shiny. Oh my gosh, that is gorgeous. We've got this big rectangle pin that almost looks like a painting of Luna with her lion head and her Patronus. I love how the colors pop, the glitter on her Patronus, and the little blue stone. Yeah, this is definitely one of my favorite pins from now on. So I have two pin banners. I have one for my normal pins and I have one for my special pins, and this is definitely gonna go on this special pin banner. Speaking of pin banners, I feel like this could be a pin banner. There is something on it. This actually resembles my pin banner, only mine is way smaller. I think it says, oh, that's so cute. I don't know if you guys can see this, but these are actually people. There's friends written all over the banner in gold. I am kind of surprised that they added this big of a pin banner in a box, but I am really, really happy with this. Okay. What do we go for next? I think we might have a candle. We do. It's an exceptionally ordinary candle. Pineapple mango scented. Oh, wow. Okay. I can totally imagine Luna buying this candle. It smells like fruit bubblegum. I never buy candles. Probably an unconscious decision because I know that I'm gonna get candles in these boxes. But still, I really love candles and I get them in these boxes, so it's a win-win for me. We may have a wearable in this box. It's a gray short sleeve t-shirt. It's a Thestral, you guys, I love it. Oh my gosh, this shirt kicks ass. I would definitely wear this. I would even wear this to work. Oh no, that might not be a good idea. I'm a psychologist. I mean, that would kind of give up the wrong impression. I love the dark gray. This is such a great color. I wonder who drew the Thestral because it looks amazing. Moving on to something that should definitely be in a Luna Lovegood box. Radish earrings. I have seen these kind of items before. I think we also got some Radish earrings in a Geek Gear special edition box, but honestly, I like these better. And they are so intricate. It's a pair of golden earrings with a beautiful red radish and three green leaves. I really, really like these. I'm definitely gonna wear them. Next up is a little potion bottle, and inside, okay, that's hilarious. Gnome saliva. We've got a bronze wax seal with an eagle, a little gnome charm, and a blue label with three angry gnomes. Oh, hold on. Ooh, it's a swirly potion. Who knew that gnomes had such beautiful saliva? I do wonder though, how do you collect gnome saliva? I mean, do you poke their nose, or do you just ask them to blow their nose, or do you take it by force? Is this the most beautiful potion I own? No, but it's definitely one of the funnier ones. I think they have added a Quibbler. Oh no, wait, it's something else. But it does look a little bit like the Quibbler. I always wonder if they do this because a lot of the Harry Potter stuff is copyrighted. Or is this just like another magazine that Xenophilius Lovegood was the editor of? It is called The Enchanter, and it is actually a full text book. That is so cool. Oh my gosh, I cannot wait to read this. That is so much fun, you guys. I love these kind of items that actually make you feel like you're living in the wizarding world. Yeah, I know, that's called denial. It's pretty much what I like to do. So does it say anywhere who created this? It says that The Enchanter was created by Danny at Wizardry Workshop. We publish articles that expose the truth. We are the one true voice of reason in the magical world, we thank you for purchasing or subscribing to our small independent news magazine. That's really cool. So Danny from Wizardry Workshop is someone that works a lot with the Wizarding Trunk. He also made the beautiful book covers. He's definitely someone that makes a lot of beautiful magical items. I am really impressed by this box, and we still have two more items left. Next up is a key. Oh, I see what they're doing. I didn't notice that before, but they actually include a key in every box. And this is, how could it not be, a Thestral key. Kind of reminds me of a seahorse. Again, this is one of those items that I absolutely love to look at, but I just never know how to display them. I wish the Wizarding Trunk and other boxes that provide keys and coins and stuff like that would give us an accessory that we can buy and just hang our keys in. But yeah, I'm a fan. I mean, I have a Thestral key now. The final item in this box, we have some purple tissue paper. What is this? I have no clue what it is. I mean, I know that Luna is associated with weird things. So this is probably the horn of some magical creature that no one else knows but her. It's definitely a quirky item, and I would have liked it better if they would have added a label at the bottom that would tell us from what kind of magical creature it came from. But maybe the spoiler card will tell us. Okay, I've put it on my desk now, and it does look really cool. Those are all the items in the Exceptionally Ordinary Special Edition box. Now let's take a quick look at the spoiler sheet. We got a total of 13 items. I wondered why they added a Thestral key. It says, this key was given to me by my father when I discovered what these horses symbolized and why I can see them. Now every time I open my school trunk, I think of my mother. Aww. Oh, the horn. It says elusive or explosive horn. This is the horn of a very rare creature, but be careful with it, as we have recently been told it may actually explode. So is that a reference to something? Am I missing it? This was such a fun box. They did an amazing job of choosing items that really represent Luna. There's a great mix between practical items and display items. I am not going to choose a favorite this time because I just have way too many. Among them are the t-shirt, the pin, the Thestral key, the lion head. However, I can choose a least favorite item, and that's the wooden ornament. I'm just not the biggest fan of wooden ornaments. I would have preferred this to be a little print or maybe a postcard or a sticker, but that's okay. We cannot like everything in a box. And that was it for today. Definitely let me know your thoughts. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, then please give it a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching, and let's stay in touch.